special guest, Cool Will, everybody. Man, it's so iced down, bro. It's cold in here. Normally, it's hot. Shit. Hey, I got, you know it, Mellow Hype. Man, come check us out. I'm truly grateful, and I appreciate all of you for coming down and watching us. Please like, share, and subscribe right here in the big sweater. Thanks to Cool Will, you feel me? Say, man. Hey, a lot of great blessings and a lot of good content coming up. So tell your mom, your dad, your granny, your aunt, your gerbil, your hamster, your cat, your dog, your reptile, your bird, your tweety bird, your Sylvester the cat. Shit, yeah, the squirrel up the street. Tell Brian, your dog, hell, everybody, man, let them know. So, before we get into it, I got a super magnificent question for both of you. How is y'all's day today?
Great, man. Lit. I had an art show last night. Just waking up today doing this.
Man, 100.
That's just like a blessing. A blessing.
Man, that's straight grinders. Oh, shit. Alright, so this episode today is all about the arts, man. Master of the arts, king of the arts, Mr. Cool Will, man. I'm truly grateful for you coming out, man, and taking some time to be here with us.
No problem, bro.
Man, I see you always on the grind, you're doing a lot of shows, and you're always on the hustle, man. So, tell us, where are you from, man?
Originally, I'm from Winfield, Louisiana. Not too many people know what that is. Mm. If you're from Louisiana, they like New Orleans or Baton Rouge.
Yeah.
It's like in central Louisiana, kind of like, probably like an hour away from Shreveport. A lot of people know what Shreveport is. So.
Yeah. Man, hey, that's real. So, I mean, now you're here in Dallas, man. You said you had an art show last night, so you traveling doing your art right now.
Yeah, man, I've been traveling for like probably 2 or 3 years. Like, at first, I was really scared to travel by myself. You know, like, you don't really know people like that, but that's how you learn to know people like that.
No, that's facts. So, man, when was the first time, like, you actually sold, like, your first sale?
My first sale was actually here in Dallas. That's why I love Dallas, though. Like,
okay, so Dallas over here is bringing the love, man. Hey, everybody, man. Dallas, Fort Worth, man. Y'all got to give it up. But, hey, Louisiana people, y'all got to come out sometime, too, man. I might have to go out there one time, man, if it's safe.
It's cool, man. It's cool, bro. It just settled down.
Yeah, 100. Okay, so when was the first time you picked up your pencil? The first pencil, like, in your first drawing?
That's probably an embryo stage.
Yeah, 100, bro. From
I don't even remember. Like, I just been drawing forever, like, on the side of my test or whatever. The teacher, like, we don't need all these cartoons on the side. Mm-hmm. You need to worry about getting your grades or whatever.
That's real. 100. Man, I'll be over here trying to drop my little stick figs on the Scantron, bro, and I got herb erase. You know what I'm saying? They be like,
man,
I be trying to do little circles. Sometimes I be trying to guess, so I make a little face with them all.
That's what art is. All about guessing. Like, nobody don't know what they doing. Like, what really is a circle? What really is a line? We don't know.
Bro, I cannot draw a line for shit, bro. My shit is coming down like a whole oak when I try to draw a circle. Man, y'all, so y'all know y'all have another special guest, my man Rafa. He came back.
Shout out to the
Stallion. Man, the Stallion, he's doing the podcast.
Facts.
Real talk, man. She need to come to Dallas so you be in Houston.
Could you do portraits?
Oh, yeah, man. I do portraits all the time. I wanted to do a Meg, though, because, like, I be having trouble doing females, so I want to do a lot.
Yeah.
I did a lot of Rihanna's. I tried to do Beyonce one time. That was cool. So I'm going to drop out of with Meg next. I don't know.
Man, I think you should go ahead and do it, bro. You got all the skills to it. So, you said the first song was in embryo stage. Do you remember your first drawing? Do you remember the first drawing that you sold?
Well, yeah. The first drawing that I sold was Randy Moss, actually, yeah. Randy Moss, stay out here, don't you?
Yeah, don't.
It was some chick. We was at a show, and I only had like one painter anyway.
Yeah.
She was like, "Man, I'm finna come get this for $100." Me never selling nothing. I'm like, "She lying." She came back and she copped it. I'm like, "Oh man, it's really real."
Yeah.
Man, that's what I was like. After that, like, I kept trying to like put my stuff in the right category to like not lowball myself.
Man, that's real. Alright, so how do you know that drawing, like, how did you know that drawing was for you? Like, when you drawing your first, like, when you drew your first, your first picture, that great? The first piece of art,
I think it's like a feeling thing. Like, when I draw, I disconnect from reality, so.
Yeah.
That's like the best thing for me. Like, if I got like a lot of stuff going on in my life, then if I can go to this place to where none of that even affected, then I'm going to be here all the time.
Yeah.
And then it's actually creating something out of, you know, the stuff that you're going through. So it's like actually healing, but you actually creating. So you're building a future out of your, like, out of your pain.
That's kind of like the first love. You're real. It's a real relationship.
So, have you, along your career, have you ever had times where you may have felt like another path could have been for you?
Oh, yeah, plenty of times.
Yeah.
That's why I retired. I was like, man, I don't know if this for me. Like, I don't know if, like, you know, like, everybody second guess. Like, I know you probably second guess this, though. Like, that's just human nature to second guess. But it's always called back. Like, if something call you back, then it's your path. It's, like, your real destiny. Every time they call back, I came back. I guess that is a relationship.
Like, yeah.
She called me, I'm running.
Nah, 100, bro. I gotta come back to the love.
That's real.
Love of my life. Shit, man.
Damn, that's crazy.
Man, Pat.
That's real.
How you feel about fitness, man?
Man, it's life. It's everything. Shoot, everything is a workout.
So, is... do you feel like sculpting your body is like another form of art as well?
Shoot, yeah. You seen the Greek statues and stuff, all that stuff they made, hieroglyphics and stuff? Man, it's like, that stuff be going for, however much.
No, 1,000, bro. Especially, hey, all the male strippers out there, man, listen. Listen, bro. Millions, fam. Millions at a night, bro. Hey, them female strippers, they ain't the only ones getting to the bag. Hey, I'm trying to go ahead and ask for employment, bro, if this podcast don't work out. So,
keep the doors open.
Nah, crazy, sorry. Alright, sculpting. Could you ever sculpt, like, actually, like, do, like, the pottery and stuff?
I sculpting stuff. I try to dip my hand in everything, but, I only sculpted one thing before. And it kind of came out boost, like I ran from that. But I want to get back into it, though.
Okay.
Like, I really want to make figurines and stuff like that.
Figurines.
Those
Little
small, like you ever seen, like, the little bait dolls and stuff like that? Or the carved doll. Like, I want to, like, kind of do something like that.
So, what is art to you?
Everything. When you ask him that, I'm like, that's his question, but I'm gonna ask him, like, bro, everything.
Yeah.
This is art.
Yeah.
We art. We was made, like, how we look, that's art. I look at everything, like, if people, like, groomed out, that's your art, that's your craft, that's you perfecting something that you want to do and making it into something else. Like, art is like brightening something, like turning something into this, putting your little style in on it and making it brighter than it was, like actually bigger than it actually was. So I feel like everything art. And everything fall in place like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was well said.
So you mentioned, you know, you being born from Louisiana and also coming down to Dallas to do a show. I also know that you do like a lot of shows. Where are some of the places you travel to, man?
I've been to New Orleans, I mean that's Louisiana. So.
Yeah.
I've been to Atlanta, I've been to Austin. San Antonio, I've been to Chicago and L.A.
That's real. So, what keeps you on that grind? What keeps you motivated to keep pushing and keep hustling?
I guess I'll say the people, I guess. Because, like, when people react to, like, your natural art, like some artists, they go by people. Like, they going to go by what people like. I just go by what I like. And I hope that the people like, and then when people come up, like last night, people was like, oh man, like that, oh man, that's all I live for. Like Like, that's gonna make me wanna go to the next show and get the next. Oh, man.
Yeah.
It just changed my life. Oh, I see the concepts and stuff in there. And I'll be like, oh, yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
That's gonna keep me going.
Okay. Yeah. So, what are some of the challenging times and what are some challenging things that you experienced in pursuit of your career?
Artist block, people stealing your ideas, support a big thing though. Like, people don't understand, like, it ain't even a like on a picture or whatever, it's just like actual support. Like, I know a lot of people that I knew and grew up with that never even took a look at my stuff, and that ain't got nothing to do with me. Like, I don't really have a problem about that, but I mean, that's not the way that I would come.
Right.
Like, I mean, I would support anybody that's actually just out here doing. I don't even got to know you like that.
Right.
Because I know how it is just actually being out here in the field and trying to do something that you really, like, passionate about and nobody not giving it a look or nothing like that. So, I guess I'll say support and, like, everything under that.
So, what are some ways that you've just been managing and just fighting through that?
Just keep going. Like, people going to support, like, they always say, like,
what keeps you going? I know for the audience it may seem, okay, he said keep you going, but, like, what keeps you going? What is getting you out of bed? What is keeping you, getting in the car with, you know, you got to lean the seat back because your back be hurting and shit, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? That right butt, you getting tired, so you got to lean just a little bit like this, a little bit better, you know what I'm saying? Like, what keeps you going through that process, man?
I don't know. I think I love it. I think it's love. Like, when you actually love something, you don't really got no explanation for it.
Yeah.
Like, I know a lot of people be in a relationship and they be like, man, I'm not really feeling like this, but I can't really leave it. That's love. Like, you love that person. There's really nothing that you can do about it. I when I wake up, like, I love to do this than rather be under a system.
Yeah.
Under a system of the government or something like that. I'd rather be working for myself and trying to put a better future out there for me and myself and my future kids than be working at a dead-end job and trying to do this and do that and we're stressing about shit that don't really matter, like, in the grand scheme.
That's some real stuff. So, I see, so branching out, like you said earlier, artists everything. So, you say you branch out, do some sculpting, of course you paint, and also you also sell your shirts as well. And so...
Yeah, that motherfucker.
Yeah, man, 100. So I know we talked a little bit about you liking Kanye and being a fan of his as well, because I'm a big fan of Kanye as well, man. 100.
Shout out, man.
Nah, for real, nah. Man, that's gonna be the real plug and shit. Nah, seriously, I gotta go tag him in this. would you go to this church? That little church, little vibe that you're going to? Are you hosting?
I mean,
where is it?
I would, but, like, that's not my way. I like his way. Like, only reason I look at it, because I look at him like an artist, I probably wouldn't go to it, but I support it.
Yeah,
like, I don't, like, you don't have to, like...
Well, it's not a church. I think it's the wrong thing. It's like a choir or something. I don't know.
Oh,
like
a gospel. I've seen that. Yeah. So, what, he be pulling up doing that at different places now?
I think they got one main place that they do it now. And so, they just go in there and they be making music, it's vibing. Yeah, I think they're selling some merch there, too.
Oh, yeah, you know they're selling merch. It's Kanye.
Yeah, so if you had an opportunity to, like, all right, where is there a max? What is the top for you? What is the, like, the peak? Is there a peak?
It's a peak, but it ain't reachable. I want to have my art in every house, in every state, in every place. So, like, I feel like that's going to keep me going forever because that's impossible. Because people get born every day.
In every house in every state?
Every house, in every borough, in every...
Even, like,
every school.
Like, everywhere. Racist KKK people out?
Everywhere.
Damn.
You mean, everywhere. It basically means you just travel the world. Yeah, you know, I love it.
Just right. Because, like, I mean, I'm out here putting myself... It ain't like I'm just doing it just to do it. I'm putting myself out here. So, that means I got myself in their house. Okay. Part of me, even if they racist, like, they bought it from me.
Yeah.
Like, you could think about what, like, you could tell them some white guy painted it or did it. I don't care. You bought it from me.
Yeah.
It's my feeling. It's the way I feel about it.
Yeah.
I don't care.
Yeah.
That's what Matt P did, right? With his right. CDs. Right. Talking about shit. If you don't care, they don't want to go ahead and pick him up, get somebody else.
Right, it's real. They bought him.
Yeah.
So, is there a targeted audience, or do you just make artists for people? Like, it's for the universe, aliens.
Right, it's for the aliens, right? Yeah, yeah. It's for the higher ups, the people that think, like, outside the box. It ain't even a box, it's a circle.
That's crazy. That's good.
Now, put me on game.
Bro. Right. It ain't no lines, it ain't no corners. It's like a circle. Like I wanna get my art to that circle. And not even that circle. I want people to look at that circle and be like, man, I wanna get in that.
Right.
Like I didn't even know that I liked that, but seeing his stuff, I like that.
Right.
That's how I want people to hop in. So it's for everybody really.
Facts, man. Alright, so 5 to 10 years from now, where do you see yourself?
Oh man, on a boat with Rihanna.
Ah, Riri.
Painting like Leonardo DiCaprio.
Ah, yeah, 100.
Yeah.
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 Okay.
But nah, real talk.
Hey,
really?
Talk.
That was about to say real talk. That's how I want to be. Like, I want to be like paint somewhere on the ocean.
Yeah.
Like some like. I still want to be able to do art. I still want to have the drive, or like, you know, but I want to be at an elevated place like than I am now.
Right.
So I just want to keep like stacking on. So in 5 years, I'll be a better me, like a better, like a 5-year-old or better me type person.
That's real. Hold on, let me get some water. I'm thirsty. With the world at your disposal, how far are you willing to travel? To sell your art and just even to do art.
I drove 24 hours to go sell art.
That's right.
I want to go everywhere I can. I really want to go overseas next though, like, and do a lot of shows over there.
So, would you go to a monk temple and like stay there, like, you know, however long your process needs to draw, so like your own little masterpiece there?
Facts, bro.
Yeah.
You said that. I didn't even have that on my list. Like, bro, do I need to put that on my, like, yeah.
Yeah.
That'll be an experience.
You said a long time.
Yeah, yeah, so, I ain't gonna lie, like, one of them, hold on, goddamn, in audio, real deal. Yeah, one of my things that I want to do once all this shit keep going off, we're gonna take, like, a little month vacation. Oh, we got to do a podcast, right? We're gonna take, like, a little week vacation, and, we're gonna go out to, like, an Indian temple, bro, and hang with some guys, bro.
That's gonna be dope.
Lining up chakras and stuff, man.
Yeah.
And hey, we're gonna talk some business out there, too, because, hey, no, it's a lot. No, serious, bro. You think you're playing? You think of Africa now?
You wanna go to Africa?
Yeah, yeah.
Dang, that's lit.
You need something about your passport, bro. Hey.
Right.
So.
Everybody get their passport, you ain't got it. You get it before you get it.
Because Donald Trump finna kill everybody. I try to hit my Kanye shit. Because what George Bush don't like. So, alright, so you go anywhere and just take some time, travel some months and just do this. Would you go out on the Pacific, go out on the, like, in the Atlantic Ocean, all secluded by yourself on the boat?
Like I said, if it was Rihanna. I really don't. I can't, yeah, like, swim like that. I'm kind of scared of the ocean. Like,
yeah, life jacket though.
Yeah,
thanks, man. Okay.
But well, I mean, like shows like Lost at Sea, that should be scaring me though. Like,
yeah,
they in Lost the sea, and like, yeah, like I couldn't do that.
No, you sound good.
Right. Like, nah, I don't know. I'll be spooked up. But I would though. Like, man, I'd do it. Like right now, my point is, I'll do anything for the experience and see what come out of it. Because so much art come out of, like, experience. That's how I do. Like, I don't do art. I just do whatever pop in my head or how I'm feeling at that moment. And I just...
So if I said, let's go down to the bottom of the ocean, the submarine, and you bring you some equipment, you bring you some art equipment with you, and I'm going to bring my vlogging camera, and you can go down there and make some content.
I'll do it, man. If I know for sure that I ain't finna die, I do it.
Fact. And Pat gonna go down there and go fight the octopus.
But it's over. I heard what you say the bottom. What you mean the bottom? Like,
yeah, you know, sometimes I watch the Discovery Channel. You fucking crazy, dog.
That's kind of like,
you know, they said, like, as a certain depth. But it got, it's like it's so much pressure that whatever try to go down, it's just gonna get crushed. Like,
oh yeah.
Boy, that nigga's one of our stupid boys.
Hey, that show was a classic, bro. I don't care what y'all say, bro.
I definitely would go down there and do some like pain with that boy.
Yeah.
Cool. With Squirrel too. Like I like, people don't like Squirrel, but I'm the type of person that like him. I'm like, bro, leave him alone. Yeah. Trying to do some art. Yeah. Like, man, you loud. You over here making all this noise. Like, bro, we trying to do art. I like Squirrel.
You saying that once you get to a certain part, the pressure be trying to like squeeze you and stuff?
Yeah, underwater, yeah. Like, supposedly, like, scientists.
So if I get you a suit to fight against it, you can go out there and fight against it.
He said, a what?
A suit like Iron Man.
Shoot. I don't know. I mean, as far as I know, they said ain't nothing going down.
What if I told you to go down there with you, bro? If I go out there and try to fight against you, bro? You going out there to go save everybody?
Oh, this thing is, this is like.
Yeah, wait, but you gotta paint us while we save everybody, though.
I don't know, bro. I would want one of them Iron Man suits. I'm doing anything. I'm doing everything. Bro, I wouldn't even be on Earth.
Oh, I ain't gonna lie to you. Well, I trade with you. I let you get this suit. I'll stay inside.
In fact,
that's it, shoot. Y'all go ahead and do that. I don't know about fighting no water.
In an Iron Man suit?
In an Iron Man suit? Shoot. Man, I'm all gonna take is one, two blasts and they done, really.
Right. Okay, so.
Really, it's right. Not gonna be a fight.
It just allows you to breathe underwater and more easily. Like your punches may actually inflict damage. So if you get bit, you won't be, it's like a, you know, you take some damage, but not like, okay, I can take a few more hits of this.
If, yeah, because I live life on the edge, like,
yep.
I'm a risk taker, like, yeah, I need to, if I ain't gonna die, I'll do it.
Yeah. Big Squid, you gonna fight one?
Big Squid?
Yeah.
No, y'all got it. I ain't fighting no squid. Iron Man suit, you know, shoot him one time, one or two times.
But you ain't got no missiles, though.
I need my check, give my check.
You don't have no missiles.
Why would I not have a missile in my Iron Man suit? So what y'all talking about? Because
like, you can't kill the animal, bro.
Yeah, we
can not. But we can't kill
it. But you just said this is for the sake of humanity.
No, we're trying to save everybody on the marine boat. Because, you know, we got the scientists that take us down there.
So basically,
say if an octopus tried to grab us.
The squid shaking the submarine got us on lockdown. Right?
Yeah, are y'all grabbing this? So he said he's going.
So it's like, hey, when y'all gotta go out there?
Yeah.
This is me. I'm gonna do it.
I mean, shit, I gotta. Yeah, man, I ain't gonna let y'all go by yourself, so.
Hey, man, shoot, we do this thing together, but shoot, y'all trying to get me to go out there by myself. I'll be like, bro. What do we have? What you say? We ain't got no missiles. What we doing here? What's the game plan, bro? What you talking about? So, yeah, I'm gonna go out there. Okay. Nice to meet you.
We're gonna be riding that ball out as soon as he dip out that ball.
So basically, somebody just bait.
That ball was just, cool, man.
Extreme limits. Extreme limits. So is there any extreme limit that you just won't go to paint? Because I'm thinking, I'm trying to push you in extreme limits, like in the midst of a volcano. You're safe, though. People pull you out, but.
I'm telling you, if I'm safe, if he tell me, man, you might get a little burnt, like a little bit, but you're going to live. I'm going to do it.
Like, bro. That's some serious shit, bro, because that right there gets you, hey, your heart going to be going crazy.
Right.
I mean, fuck cloud chasing. Bro, that's
shit, that's for real.
No, 1,000. Man, we're gonna put Will Smith to shame.
That's one of my favorite people. That's why people call me Will, though. Actually, yeah. My name is Desi.
For real?
Yeah. That's right. I got that name in middle school.
At 100, man. The Fresh Prince of the King of Art, man. Shit, me and his name. So, alright. Now, you briefly spoke about being in retirement at one point. Man, what brought you out of retirement? What got you into it?
Like going into it, it was like art just started to be overwhelming. Like everything was coming at one time, and I was like,
too many projects.
Too many projects. Too many like problems. Like everything was happening at one time. Like I was getting a lot of commissions, and like a lot of stuff was happening, and I was like, I'm kind of overwhelmed. I don't know if I could like. Keep putting up this amount of like, cause it's a lot of mental. I don't know if I can keep putting my mental through this like that. So I was like, man, let me just. I ain't. It wasn't even a I'm gonna come back. It's like, bro, I'm done. I'm done. I'm not coming back.
That's how it was.
Yeah. But I had came out of it like it's gonna come out. Like, if you love it, it's gonna come back. I feel like I just needed the time away from it or something, like, just to get my mind, like, refocused and shit.
That's real. Okay. And what brought you out of it, though? I know you said the love, but, like...
I mean, like, yo, like, everybody was DMing me, like, yeah. You. They was like, bro, you tripping, yeah. Bro. Like, post some art.
Yeah.
Like, nigga, what are you doing? Yeah. Like, we need this. I'm like, bro, oh, for real?
Yeah.
For real, real? So I'm like, oh, yeah. I ain't finna come out right now, but I'm definitely coming out. I ain't let nobody know that I was finna retire, but I was like, yeah. And I did like 20 pieces ever since I've been out retired.
Dang, come back
here. You're gonna be super strong, bro. Man, like, so, hey, everybody, man, say y'all great, get it while y'all can, so one of a kind legend coming through.
It's definitely prices
man. Ain't going up. Man, hey, fuck, what's that dude name? Pistachio? Or is that the
Pistachio.
Hey, that's a...
What you say, Leonardo DiCaprio? Is that even
someone? Yeah, him too. Yeah, all them old ass white dudes, they took the ears off and shit.
Oh, you talking about Van Gogh?
Yeah, him too.
Van Gogh. I like Warhol, though. Warhol and Basquiat.
Is he black?
Warhol, like, the guy with the glass and, like, the little...
The afro?
He would, like, wear, like, turtlenecks, black tie. So.
Yeah, and he'd be, like, doing
cameras. He'd wear glasses like that.
Yeah.
Like, y'all a TV show? Damn, TV
I know he do like, I don't know if it's TV or YouTube videos. It was like video. He was standing there painting.
He should paint the tree. is that the right guy?
No, oh, you talking about Bob Ross.
I sent you a picture of the guy. Picture of him, like, they put like his picture in front of a... Try it.
Yeah, like that's Bob Ross. Okay. Deadpool like did like a parody.
Okay. Well, if you respect him, then alright, I guess that's yeah, alright. So, alright. So, if you could leave yourself a message for your future self, what would it be?
Invest in yourself. Still, like, I don't know, like, the more I do it, the less I started. Like, I was doing a lot of shirts at first, and I was doing, like, watching videos to, like, get different feels and stuff. Like, I stopped doing that, but then, like, after I retired and came back, I got back into it. So I'll tell them, like, I know you're going to go through that again because you just went through it. So stay invested and stay, like, yourself. I don't want to be 5 years. I don't want to come see you in 5 years and you're just a bitch. if I see you and you're not doing what we supposed to be doing, we definitely gonna have problems. Like, I don't want myself to be like a dip.
Right. That's some serious shit. Okay. So that's some real shit. So what helps you build that self discipline, that self accountability?
Trial and error. Cause once you go out there and you do it, you'll see. And once you go out there and don't do it, you're gonna see. You're gonna be like, I told you. Like, I think your mental talk to you. Like, everybody be like, man, it's premonitions or it's like ghosts or something. Like, nah, that's your subconscious telling you what you need to be doing. Like, I try to listen to it now because I know I haven't listened to it in the past and
took L's. Ignoring it,
right. That's how you take L. You don't listen to better judge.
Yeah. Damn.
Yeah, eventually that's gonna go away the more you ignore it.
Yeah. That person, that voice is gonna stop. You ain't gonna hear it no more. And that's just gonna be. That's why so many people be in dark places. They don't hear that voice no more. They done killed that little kid inside of them that was telling them, bro, we need to be getting to this point. This is how you get to that point. Like, you have fun doing this. Some people work that 9-to-5, and that 9-to-5 could kill that voice easily. Like, yeah. Outside relationships could kill that voice. Negativity could kill that voice. So, like, I'll be trying to, like, preserve all of that.
Thanks. Okay, so you briefly just mentioned relationships. On the constant grind, hustling, going to different venues and just meeting different people and, building different bonds and relationships, business relationships, and even great, probably new friendships and team friendships. How do you manage a relationship, a dating relationship? And is that something that's possible for you?
I think it's possible. It's kind of hard, though, because, like, people got to really understand you. Like, for a person that's an artist, like, they have to, like, actually have to sit down and actually study you like a book. If you really want to be in this person's life, you got to know, like, sometimes that, like, he going through an artist block. He don't want to talk right now. Like, some people don't understand that, and they look at it like, well, it's me. I hate when people look at it like it's a them. It's not a you. I'm, like, super complex. Like, I, like, sometimes, like, I don't even try to get in relationships. I just be friends with people. Like, I can't, because I know me. I know I'm really invested in this, and I know you don't understand how invested I am, so it wouldn't even be feasible for both of us. And I know that. She probably don't know that, but I know that. So I try to keep it like that. But I think it's possible, like, that person really just got to, like, commit to understanding, like, what it really is, like, how do you really work. And I think that's how it is with, like, celebrities and stuff. People that really be out here grinding, I guarantee you their partner understand everything about them.
Right.
Like, it ain't nobody out here that can tell them better than their partner.
Right.
So I feel like that's the only way it could work.
Right, okay. So, how can a person get to understand who Cool Will is?
I talk a lot, though, so, like, people could pick up on it. Like, if you care, you'll pick up on it. You'd be like, oh yeah, he cool, he like this, like, stuff like that. And the more people, I see people, like, acceptable to who I am, because, like, if I'm an art person, and I talk about art, if I see them, I draw back, and I'm like, yeah, I don't want to, like, give off the wrong vibe, or be putting my energy out there, and they ain't even trying to receive it. So, like, I'm an easy person to, like,
right.
You'll probably know, like, meeting me the first time, you'll probably know mostly a lot of stuff about me. Like, if you that type of person that's, like, can catch those details and stuff. Like,
okay.
Yeah.
All right, so, now, I know you mentioned Riri. All right? If you get any, is there any other artists, whether it be musical, sports, or anything, any art form, any artist in general, or any person, anybody, whom would you work with? And,
Rihanna, Zendaya,
Rihanna, man, you got
to
get
shout out. She got to come on with it now, because you put it out there in the universe so much, man.
She should let me, like, that could be, like, a dope experience. Like, you could be there, like, you could be
fucking. Nah, 100, bro. We got that great content. Sorry, Joe Budden, you're going to miss this one. Shit, for real. Okay. Rihanna, who else?
I like Zendaya. I like her art. Like, how, like, she just seemed like an art person. Like, that's real receptive to art.
Okay.
Just because I would want to do some ratchet shit.
Like, want it. Okay. So, you ever thought about having kids?
I definitely want to have kids. But I feel like, I know a friend, he got kids, and it's kind of hard for him to stay on the art grind because it's like, art itself is his own kid.
Yeah.
You got a baby, you got to nurture, you got to take care of it. And that's like having two kids. So, what if you got three kids? You got four kids.
Yeah.
I mean, I do, but, like, it just ain't been in the cards. Like, yeah, I didn't put it in my cards yet.
So, boys or girls? How many kids?
Man, I got a niece, like, I, like, basically raised her until she was, like, two.
I mean, like, if you could have, like, boy or girl?
I don't know, because I got a nephew, too, and he, like, I'm like, dang, I thought I wanted boys. Bad.
Yeah.
But I don't know, I think, I really don't have a purpose. I really want to have twins, a boy and a girl, and I'll be done for life.
Yeah, my sister.
Okay.
I'll be done, man. I'm done. I got the perfect. Like, they the same age. I would want a boy first to watch out this sister.
So, if he wanted to pick up art too, would you be all for it?
Oh, man. Hell yeah. Like, I would feel offended. Like, yeah. Oh, man. I don't want to be like your daddy.
Yeah.
How lame dad. You don't want to be like your old man.
You be on Twitter?
Yeah, I'll be on Twitter, but, like, I don't really be on it like that.
y'all seen this one little kid, he probably like 5 or 6. He was on the sand throwing Sonic.
Yeah, seen that?
Yeah, man.
I think that's dope though, cause like the thing is, the older you get, the less creative it is. Kids are the most creative. Like think about all the little fantasies and stuff they create in their head. Kids, if they actually had the like the preciseness of art, that'd be the best artist in the world. That'd be the best like category of artist. I wouldn't even be an artist. They'd be shitting on you.
Crazy. So, do you believe in spirits, ghosts?
Yeah, I believe in everything. I feel like if it came up, then it's a backstory to it. But I believe in, like, that spirit manifested itself. Mm-hmm. Like, if you, somebody getting hunted or something, like, it's coming from somewhere. You letting that energy in. I think it's all about energy, though. It's whatever kind of energy you let in, that's what's going to come out.
So I put you in a haunted house.
And if I'm in a haunted house and I believe that it's ghosted her, if somebody told me and I believe it, I'm definitely going to see ghosts. Like, that's just how it works.
So I put you in my house to go draw. And for a whole 2 days, you staying in there?
I'm not doing that. I'm not doing it. Like, she's safe. Like I said, if I did it, I'd be safe. But that's my mental.
Yeah.
Like, that ain't even, my body would be safe. My mental would be trash.
Yeah, that one, I feel you. I'm on the same boat, man. I got dipped out of there.
Yeah.
I don't fuck with spiritual shit, man.
I mean, I do, but like, I believe in it, but I don't fuck with it.
Yeah, no, I believe in it.
I'm not about to dip my hand in it.
Them demons and shit, you gotta go.
Oh, man, so just don't direct your energy towards that.
Because you host a boot camp inside of my house, bro. Where you get paid $5,000 per person.
Oh.
And you get like 20 people in it.
That sounded like a celebrity, like Halloween party type thing. I want to do something like that, man.
In the boot camp, bro, in the haunted house, you know for certain it's demons. Shit tip over. The last person who was up there got possessed.
Oh man, I witnessed this and I'm finna.
Like, you know of it. Like, they got it on video.
Finna go in.
And they pay, that's where the hosting spot is. $5,000 a head. You know what I'm saying? You got 25, 30 people in there.
Let's get it, man. We bring fish
to
it. Rosemary, sage, we getting all that. Everybody put something in your pocket, put a necklace on. Bracelets, rings, we good to go.
A 3-day boot camp. And y'all gotta stay there. You holding it down?
That's
per day too.
Oh yeah.
Let's get the bag.
Make it that week. I need a whole week.
So yeah, man, might as well. Shoot. Make it a little couples retreat.
Crazy. So have you ever went to one of like the little things of Civic
Paint? I haven't been to one, but like I've been asked. Like, I don't know how I would do in that situation.
What kind of date would you take a female to?
The movies. Like everything I'm gonna take you to the art show or something like that. I'm like, I'm an artist. Yeah. Why would I take you to an art show?
To go see somebody else.
Real shit. Hey, listen. Okay. That's what's up, man. Sometimes, man, the most simplest things be the best things for us. I promise you. For real. Cause I ain't been to movies in a long time, nigga. I'm still trying to go.
Yeah, when you said that, when I went to see Annabelle, I'm like,
man. It came out already?
Yeah, I watched it.
I didn't go there.
It came out Friday.
And see, I was trying to go see that. I ain't seen Toy Story yet. I'm still trying to see John Wick now.
I ain't seen John Wick.
I seen John Wick. That mother's going crazy.
Oh, man.
I got a few ideas I want to talk to you about, so we're going to wrap this up, too. So, wrapping it up, you basically, you know, said that the message that you would lead to leave yourself would be, you know, basically make sure that you accomplish the thing that you accomplish and make sure all the hard work that you put into right now is fruitful in the beginning, that you didn't let it all go to waste.
Yeah.
And you also said that you're willing to travel to any extreme besides a haunted house, y'all. Yeah.
That's gonna be good.
Nah, that's gonna be a fucking crazy player. You said that. Did you tell me the first drawing that it was that you?
That was the painting with the Randy Moss.
Randy Moss. He travels to a lot of different places, and he will be able to travel to. Hey, we're gonna get this India trip planned too, man. I ain't gonna lie to you. You know, be serious. stay tuned, man. We got a lot of good plans, and it won't be cool when it's come back, man. It won't be the last time y'all see him, man.
Oh, definitely, man. Definitely,
it's lit. Man, 100. So I appreciate you coming out, Cool Will, man. 100.
What's up, buddy, man? Yeah, I gotta check out his art too, man. I saw a few of his paintings on Instagram and stuff like that, man.
Man, it's going crazy. And for all of y'all on the other side, it's going crazy. So
definitely want no drama.
So, man, yo, like, share, subscribe right here in Cool Will's Biggest with him, man. Hey, that man done did it again, masterpiece. So, man, y'all blessed too, because I really didn't want to let y'all know he did it, man. I was trying to keep that on the low. Hey, this shit finna go crazy. But I gotta let y'all know, man, this man finna be a legend. And I promise you, bro, y'all better go ahead and get all the merch you can, because once it's gone, hey, I promise you, everybody who got it, hey, we billionaires. Hey, that's it, man. Mellow Hype, Cool Will, it's here, the Kings and Queens podcast, man. This is it. Facts.